गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, वेलकम टू द बायोलॉजी क्लास। आई होप यू ऑल आर हैप्पी एंड हेल्दी एट होम। इन द लास्ट वीडियो ऑलरेडी वी हैव स्टडी अबाउट दैट व्हाट इज मीन बाय सेल, डिस्कवरी ऑफ द सेल, डिस्कवरी ऑफ माइक्रोस्कोप एंड सेल थ्योरी। दिस लेक्चर इज द कंटिन्यूस वीडियो ऑफ द सेल चैप्टर। मीन्स आई थिंक यू नो दैट व्हाट इज मीन बाय सेल। Cell is the structural and functional unit of all living thing. Means in our body there are different cell: nerve cell, brain cell, body cell, blood cell, skin cell, bone cell. There are different cells which are present in our body, okay, and they are performing the particular function. Means you know what is mean by cell. Cell is the structural and functional unit of all living thing. And in that video we are going to study about that the structure of cell. But what is the actual structure of the cell? Got it? Let us start the video. First of all we will see what is the difference between plant cell and animal cell. You know, cell is also one kind of the living things. Means see, organism have a many organ. Means human being, hands, nose, eyes, there are so many organ we have and we are performing the particular function. Same like that, cell is also have a so many organ like structure. These organ is called as the cell organelles. These organ is called cell organelle, and these all organelles are performing the function like our organ. Got it? Cell have a many important part which is present in the cell. These important part of the cell is called as the organelles. Let us see what is the difference between plant cell and animal cell. This is the animal cell and this is a plant cell. The main difference between the animal cell and plant cell is the cell wall. The plant cell have a cell wall and the animal cell is a absent cell wall. It is only cell membrane. The cell membrane is a common. Cell membrane is present animal cell also, plant cell also, but only the cell wall is present in the plant cell. Got it? And another difference is the vacuole. See, vacuoles, the animal cell have a small vacuoles, in the plant cell have a large vacuoles. Why the plant cell is contain the large vacuole? Because the plant contain the cell sap into the vacuole. Cell sap means what? The watery substance which is contain the nutrient. This is called as the cell sap, and plant is store the cell sap into the vacuole. So the plant cell have a large vacuoles and the animal cell have a small vacuoles. Got it? What is the difference between plant cell? Means whenever we are observe the cells, we can identify with the two main things which is present in animal cell and which is present in the plant cell. Due to these two things we can distinguish between which cell is animal cell and which cell is plant cell. Plant cell wall which is present in only plant cell, and the large vacuoles is present in only plant cell. Means see, there are so many organelles are present in the plant cell, but the three most important organelles are present each and every cell is a cell membrane. Cell membrane is also present each and every cell, nucleus and cytoplasm. Means three essential parts which is present in the cell. Means the bacteria, amoeba, it is also one kind of the cell. There are so many organelles like mitochondria, chloroplast, Golgi body which is present in the cell, but three main essential organelles is cell membrane, nucleus and cytoplasm. Means cell mein kuch ho ya nahi ho, but ye three parts is very important to present in the cell. Got it? There are so many organelles like mitochondria, chloroplast, vacuoles are present in the cell. There are two main parts of the cell. One is the living part and non-living part. All part of the cells are living, means all organelles which is present in the cells are living part of the cell. Only the cell membrane, cell wall, vacuoles and fat droplets, granules, these and nucleoplasms, these three parts is the non-living part of the cell. Another, all organelles are living part of the cell. Got it? There are two part of the cell, living and non-living. All organelles, endoplasmic reticulum, mitochondria, ribosomes, lysosomes, centrioles, nucleus, all are the living part of the cell. Only the cell wall, vacuoles, granules and nucleoplasms. Nucleoplasms are non-living part of the cell. Let us see the one by one, each and every organelle's details. Got it? What is the cell? This is the structure of cell. This is the animal cell and this is a plant cell. I explained the difference between animal cell and plant cell. The cell wall is present in only plant cell. The large vacuoles are present in only plant cell. Another organelle is centrioles, centrosomes, which is present in only animal cell. And the main function of centrioles is division of cell during the cell division. Later, I will explain in details. Got it, student? Let us see the each and every organelles of the cell. See, first upon, let we see the cell membrane and cell wall. I told you, cell membrane is the living part of the cell. Cell membrane, see. Cell membrane is outer covering of the cell. Means each and everything get a shape when it covered. It is present the outer covering. See our house. There are a four wall. So it is make a room. Means it is the outer covering of the cell. It's called as the cell membrane. Plant cell is also have a cell membrane. And outer covering of the cell membrane have a cell wall. Cell membrane is very important part of the cell. It is the semi-permeable membrane. Semi-permeable membrane means which? The membrane which is allowed only essential substance which enter and exit into the cell. So, cell membrane is called as the semi-permeable, selectively permeable membrane. Means it regulate the entry and exit of the important part. Means the part, the things which is required to the cell, which is only allowed to enter into the cell. Got it? Means the cell membrane means what? The outer covering of the cell. It give the shape of the cell. It is the living part of the cell. And it also separate the cell content from its surrounding. Means see, there are so many cells. In between the cells have a space, intercellular space. It contain the many nutrient, many substance, tissue fluids. This selectively, this cell membrane is separate the internal content of the cell from its surrounding, and it is the semi-permeable membrane. Semi-permeable membrane means what? It allowed only the substance which is enter, which required to the cell. Plant cell is also cell membrane, and outer covering of the cell membrane is the cell wall. Cell wall is the non-living thing. Cell membrane is the living thing, but living membrane, but cell wall is the non-living membrane. It is give the rigidity to the plant cell. It permeable membrane means the cell membrane, cell wall is the permeable membrane. It allowed the each and every substance to enter and exit into the cell. The cell wall is made from cellulose. Cellulose is a hard substance. Got it? What is mean by cell membrane and cell wall? Let us revise. Cell membrane is the outer covering of the cell. It gives the shape of the cell and it separates the cell from outer surrounding. It is the living membrane. It is the selectively permeable membrane, means it allowed only necessary substance to enter and exit of the cell. And cell wall is present in only plant cell. It also gives the shape and rigidity to the plant cell. It is the preliminary membrane, means it allowed the all substance to enter and exit into the cell. Got it, student? What is the cell membrane? Let us see. Next organelles of the cell is a cytoplasm. Cytoplasm is the fluid. It is the liquid part of the cell. Means see, all this part, all the watery fluid, transparent fluid, which is present in the cell is called as the cytoplasm. It is the liquid medium and it contain, means all the organelles is contained in the this fluid and they perform the particular function. Cytoplasm contain the many enzymes, chemicals and they carried out the many metabolic reaction. Got it? Cytoplasm is what? The liquid part of the cell. It is the living part of the cell. Liquid part. It's called as the cytoplasm. Cytoplasm is, there are many chemical reaction take place in the cytoplasm. It is always mitochondria, lysosomes, all organelles is present. It is a scatter in the cytoplasm. Got it? And it contain the many metabolic activities. Means there is contain many chemicals. Means the respiration, synthesis of the proteins. There are many functions which is performed by the cell and these metabolic activities occur in it cytoplasm. Got it? Cytoplasm means what? Cytoplasm means the liquid medium, the liquid watery transparent colorless liquid which is present in the cell. It contains the many chemicals, many enzymes, many metabolic reactions which is carried out in the cytoplasm. Got it? Next organelles of the cell is endoplasmic reticulum. See, student, you understood what is mean by cell membrane, cell wall and cytoplasm? It is the essential part of the cell. Endoplasmic reticulum, it is the organelle, it is the rough organelles, it is the double membrane organelles in regular network. See, this is the endoplasmic reticulum. This part is called as the endoplasmic reticulum. Means it is the like that structure. And these are, means the inner end is attached to the nuclear membrane and outer end is attached to the cell membrane. Means see, this is a cell, this is a nucleus and the irregular part of the cell is called as the endoplasmic reticulum. The inner end is attached to the nuclear membrane and outer end is attached to the cell membrane. Got it? There are two types of the endoplasmic reticulum. Smooth endoplasmic reticulum and rough endoplasmic reticulum. Means see, the endoplasmic reticulum, it present the small droplets, small granules. It's called as the ribosomes. These endoplasmic reticulums are present the ribosomes, means the endoplasmic reticulum attach the ribosomes. This endoplasmic reticulum is called as the rough endoplasmic reticulum. And the main function of the rough endoplasmic reticulum is help to the protein synthesis into the cell. The endoplasmic reticulum, it also give the support to the cell. It is also form supporting framework of the cell. Got it? And smooth endoplasmic reticulum means the endoplasmic reticulum which absent the ribosomes on it. This endoplasmic reticulum is called as the smooth endoplasmic reticulum. And what is the main function of smooth endoplasmic reticulum? To synthesize the lipids, flat globules. Got it? What is mean by endoplasmic reticulum? See, it is the irregular shape which is present in the cytoplasm. It is the rough and smooth endoplasmic reticulum. The smooth endoplasmic reticulum help to manufacturing the fat granules, fat molecules, and it also support the framework of the cell and it help to synthesize the proteins. Got it? Next part of the cell organelles is ribosomes. Ribosomes means see, in the cell scatter the small granules. These small granules seen small balls like structure is called as the ribosomes. These ribosomes are scattered in the all part of the cell. Some granules are attached to the endoplasmic reticulum. It is called as the rough endoplasmic reticulum. And what is the main function of ribosomes? Synthesis of protein. You know, protein is very important to us. Protein is the bodybuilding material, and the main function of ribosomes to synthesize the protein. The ribosome is also called as the protein factory. Got it? Ribosome means what? The small granules which is scattered into the cytoplasm. Some small granules which is attached to the endoplasmic reticulum. These small granules are freely in the cytoplasm attached to the endoplasmic reticulum. These freely granules is called as the ribosomes, and main function of ribosomes to synthesize of the protein. Understood what is mean by ribosomes? Next cell organelle is mitochondria. It is very important part of the cell. Mitochondria, it is also called as the powerhouse of the cell, because why? The mitochondria is main to produce the energy and store the energy at a ATP. ATP means what? Adenosine triphosphate. It is the currency of energy. Got it? Mitochondria, it is a oval in shape. There are two membranes, outer membrane and inner membrane. The inner membrane is the finger-like projection. Inner membrane is a finger-like projection, and this finger-like projection is called as the cristae. Means, why it is a finger-like? Because it gives the large surface area to produce the energy. Got it? Mitochondria, it is the oval in shape. There are two membrane of the mitochondria, outer membrane and inner membrane. Inner membrane means, see, this is the outer membrane and inner membrane like that. And this finger-like projection, is called as the cristae. It is also like that structure is present in each cristae. And the main function of mitochondria is production of energy. So it is called as the powerhouse of energy. In the respiration lesson, we have studied about that. The glycolysis, Krebs cycle. Got it? In the previous classes, you have studied. What is mean by Krebs cycle? Means the glucose molecule, breakdown of glucose molecule and release the 38 ATP molecule in the mitochondria. Means mitochondria is known as the powerhouse of cell, because the main function of mitochondria to produce the energy and to store the energy as a form of ATP. Got it, student? Remaining cell organelles like that lysosomes, centrosomes, plastid, nucleus, I will explain in my next video. In that video, let us revise. We have studied about that the structure of cell. We have studied about that the difference between animal cell and plant cell. We have studied the living part of the cell and non-living part of the cell. Got it? There are three necessary parts of the cell is a cytoplasm, cell membrane and nucleus. We have studied the cell organelles like mitochondria. It is also called as the powerhouse of the cell. Ribosomes, it is the synthesis of the protein. It is the protein factory. Endoplasmic reticulums, then cytoplasm, it is the liquid medium which is present in the cell. It contains the many enzymes, chemicals and many metabolic reactions which is carried out into the cytoplasm. We have seen the cell membrane and cell wall. Cell membrane is very important part because it gives the shape of the cell. One thing is remaining. The cell membrane have a small pores. Cell membranes have a small pores, and these pores is allowed the exchange of the important things from inter of the cell and leave of the cell. Got it? Means the cell membrane have a fine pores, and through these pores द सब्सटेंस इज एंटर एंड एग्जिट फ्रॉम द सेल. अंडरस्टूड स्टूडेंट? What is the actual structure of cell? In my next video, I will explain remaining cell organelles. Thank you.